Oh.
Oh. Okay. Wait, what?
Oh.
It wasn't live?
You guys didn't need an intro.
I thought I hit the button. My bad.
Yeah, it's spiky.
Okay. Well, we're actually commentating now. Sorry.
Guys, why didn't you tell us in the comments?
Twitch chat has failed us, as it always does.
Twitch chat has let you down.
Twitch chat. Okay. I don't feel motivated to commentate.
It's okay. You can just say the exact same things all over again. It's fine.
Comes in with the Scooby getting off that stage and go back for another reset. But he comes in with the thing. Zephyriel has to play a more patient game just to get in on it. But
Bud's hitting on both a life and burst lead, forcing Zeph to come to him.
That's not good. You don't want Gengar to have control. But there you go, going for the knockdown. If he can get him back with one more knockdown, he can probably take it. I'm going with the Billy Bond, give him to that frame lock.
And that's literally Zeph calling out the Rotom bit earlier, but Bud ready this time.
He's being too aggressive. You gotta be more patient. What's going on here? But yeah. a good start from Sir Spud. Sir Spud taking advantage of the reactions coming in there. Wonder how Zephyriel is gonna think about this and go in into the guy.
I was gonna say something, but I forgot what I was gonna say.
Hello, Jen.
Jen.
Hello.
Hello, Ricky. All right.
So going into game two, no change of supports.
All right, see how he's going to approach it. Going in with more of a patient.
I don't know how much of Magius is working out for Zephyriel there, but on the same token, I don't see I don't think Rotom was working out very well for Spud either.
I don't know. Rotom is pretty good for, Charizard to catch him out of the anti and make him more slower, because the more slower, the more Gengars get more advantage.
That's fair, but I mean, he did call it up the second time, but the first time he used it, Zeph just took it full screen and did nothing with it. And
nice
Bud is very, Bud. Yeah, very
Ooh,
good at calling
taking out that life lead right there, going in with the meaty Scooby. And gets off with the read and the crit, taking that match right there. No, that's not game. It's
down.
It's a point.
Look, terms are interchangeable.
Life.
Off stream, gonna get Zanillite and Game Genie.
Alright, see what's going in. Zephyriel just needs to get this one dual phase in and then get that meaty, and then Gengar is out of disadvantage on his block. But he has to be patient. He's starting to be more patient.
Pressure, slowly throwing
out the deck. There you go. Getting in with that thing. Gets in the dual phase,
into the
corner.
Catches the
CAC. Ooh, all he has to do is read this right. But no, he iframes in there, getting the Scooby. Oh no, he's stuck in a wall, getting up with that nice damage. Gengar is not supposed to do damage, guys.
Yeah.
Ooh, hitting him with the Rotom. Is going to jump. Really can't do any moves. Oh, it goes in for the
hop. That's what I mean. Zeph deliberately taking that and validating the threat of Rotom.
Goes in for the hop. Going to back out, but that's not safe.
Yeah.
He's playing good, but he needs to be more backing up. Zephyriel needs to be more patient, because he's literally playing off a reaction right now and going in onto what's going on. Comes in with the... I forgot what that Pokemon's called. Rip my life.
Yeah, now Zeph was, in terms of like Dragon Claw Oki, Zeph was talking about this. He likes it because it's plus and it does a lot of chip and it does a lot of shield damage. But also Spud has been very good at calling them out with CAs, and that's a lot of the damage that got him that set.
Quick game coming off there. Sir Spud coming off the winner.
Yeah.
Zephyriel did a good match. He should have been more patient than that, but